Welcome back, friends. In Elite tutorial, I am S.K. Prashad, explaining the remaining topics of previous video. We are discussing about nature and significance of management. In previous video, I have explained some topics, and the remaining topics will be explained in this video. Today we are going to discuss importance of management. There are five importance of management. These are as follows. It helps in achieving group goals. It increases the efficiency of employee. It creates a dynamic organization. It helps in achieving personal objective. And the fifth is, it helps in development of society. Now we are going to discuss achieving group goals. Management creates a teamwork and coordination in the group. Managers give common direction to individual efforts in achieving the overall goal of the organization. Second is, increases efficiency. Management increases efficiency by using resources in the best possible manner to reduce cost and increase productivity. Next one is, create dynamic organization. Management helps employees to overcome their resistance to change and adopt as per changing situation to ensure its survival and growth. And the next topic is, achieving personal objective. Management helps the individual to achieve their personal goals while working towards organizational objectives. The next one is, development of society. Management helps in the development of society by producing good quality products, creating employment opportunities, and adopting new technology. And now the next topic is, nature of management. It means, what is management? Is the management a science? Is the management an art, or is the management a profession? Now we will discuss management as a science. Science is a systemized body of knowledge that is based on general truths which can be tested anywhere and anytime. It contains the features of science, such as systemized body of knowledge, principle based on experiments and observations, universal validity. As the principle of management are not as exact as the principle of pure science, so it may be called an inexact science. The prominence of human factor in the management make it or social science. And now we will discuss management as an art. Art refers to skillful and personal application of existing knowledge to achieve desired results. It can be acquired through study, observation, and experience. The features of art are as follows. Existence of theoretical knowledge, personalized application based on practice and creativity. In management also, a huge volume of literature and books are available on different aspects of management. Every manager has his own unique style of managing things and people. He uses his creativity in applying management techniques, and his skills improve with regular application. Since all the features of art are present in management, so it can be called an art. And now we will discuss management as a profession. As we know, profession means an occupation for which specialized knowledge and skills are required. An entry is restricted. The main features of profession are as follows: well-developed body of knowledge, restricted entry, professional association, ethical code of conduct, and service motive. Management does not fulfill all the features of a profession, and thus it is not a full-fledged profession, because anybody can proclaim to be a manager, because compulsory education degree or license is not required to be a manager. Besides, there are not any formal ethical code of conduct which are required to be observed. And now, as usual, there is a question for you. The first question is, give one feature of professor, which is satisfied by management. And the answer is well-defined body of knowledge. And the next question is, give one feature of profession which is not satisfied by the management. And the answer is restricted entry. Now we will discuss about the level of management. As you can see in your screen that there is a triangular shape is designed. In this triangular shape, there are two arrows are also drawn. First of all, we will discuss about the triangular shape. This is the level of management. The level of management is divided into three parts. The first part is top level, second part is middle level, and the last is lower level. The responsibility and accountability increases from bottom to top, and the authority decreases from top to bottom. And now we will discuss them separately. Top level of management. It consists of chairperson, chief executive officer, chief operating officer or equivalent, and their team. The main task is to integrate and to coordinate the various activities of the business, framing policies, formulating organizational goals, and strategy, bearing the responsibility for the impact of activities of the business on society. And next one is the middle level of management. It consists of divisional or departmental heads, plant superintendents, and operational managers, etc. The main tasks are to apply the policies of the top level management to ensure the availability of resources to implement policies, to coordinate all activities, ensure availability of necessary personnel, and assign duties and responsibilities to them. And the next one is lower level of management. It is also called supervisory level of management. It consists of foreman and supervisor, etc. The main task is to ensure actual implementation of the policies as per directions, bring workers, grievances, before the management and maintain discipline among the workers. Maintain the quality of output and minimize wastage. Now, as usual, there are some questions for you. At which level of management are the managers responsible for the welfare and survival of the organization? And the answer is the top level of management. And now, the next question is in your screen. Managers at the top level spend more time during this function of management. Name it. It is middle level of management. And now the next question is, name the level at which managers are responsible for implementing and controlling the plans, maintaining the quality of output. It is the lower level of management or supervisory level. It is also called operational level of management. Now we will discuss about the function of management or the elements of management. There are five functions of management. It is start from planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and last is controlling. Now we will start from planning. It implies setting goals and objectives in advance and developing a way to achieve them. And next is organizing. It is to assign duties, grouping tasks, establishing authority, and allocating resources required to carry out a specific plan. Next one is staffing. It is finding the right people for the right job by following a series of steps and includes training and development. And now the next one is directing. It is leading, influencing, and motivating employees to perform the task assigned to them. It includes four activities: supervision, communication, leadership, and motivation. Next one is controlling. It is monitoring the organizational performance towards the maintaining of organizational goals. Now, as usual, there is a question for you. Identify the function of the management. The first question is motivating employees and giving instruction to them to perform the task assigned to them is known as directing. Second is recruitment and selection of the personnel. It is staffing. And next one is finding out deficiencies in implementation of plans. It is controlling. And fourth one is preparing a blueprint for future. It is planning. And last is process of defining and grouping activities of an enterprise to establish authority relationship. It is organizing. And now we move to the next point, that is coordination. Coordination is to synchronize the various activities of an organization. In the context of business unit, the meaning of coordination is to balance its various activities such as purchase, sales, production, finance, personnel, etc. so that objective of business can easily be achieved. Lack of coordination results in overlapping duplication, delay, and chores. Now we will discuss the characteristics or nature of coordination. The first is it integrates group efforts. Second is it ensures unity of action. Next is it is a continuous process. It is all pervasive function. It is the responsibility of all managers. And last is it is a deliberate function. Now we will discuss them separately. Coordination integrates group efforts. It integrates diverse business activities into purposeful group activity, ensuring that all people work in one direction to achieve organizational goals. Next is coordination ensures unity of action. It directs the activities of different departments and employees towards achievement of common goals and brings unity in individual efforts. Then, coordination ensures unity of action. It directs the activities of different departments and employees towards achievement of common goals and brings unity in individual efforts. Now, coordination is a continuous process. It is not a specific activity matter. It is required at all levels in all departments till the organization continues its operation. Coordination is all pervasive function. It is universal in nature. It synchronizes the activities of all levels and departments as they are interdependent to maintain organizational balance. The next one is coordination is the responsibility of all managers. It is equally important at all the three top, middle, and lower level of management. Thus, it is the responsibility of all managers that they make efforts